Oh, hey, Goulash here, and welcome to my October series, covering the early history of the Treehouse of Horror Halloween specials from the iconic animated series, The Simpsons. These videos are also some much-needed promotion of my new channel, The Gulag, covering family-friendly horror shows and movies. Subscribe to The Gulag today. New videos are on the way. Link in the description. Enough self-promotion, though. In these videos, I will be covering the first four Treehouse of Horror Simpsons episodes. Some would say that the Treehouse of Horror episodes in the first 10 years of the show are the best, and those people would be correct. Even the worst Treehouse of Horror episodes in The Simpsons' first 10 seasons are better than the best Treehouse of Horror episodes in The Simpsons' last 20 seasons. It's just science. In this first video, I will naturally be covering the first Treehouse of Horror episode, Shocker, released as the third episode of the second season on October 25th, 1990. Season 1 had no Halloween episode, but that first season was a total mess production-wise anyway. They were still trying to figure out what the show looked like, and the Halloween episodes are the hardest to make because they involve designing totally new characters, redesigning familiar characters, and creating whole new backgrounds that will only appear for a single episode. After season 2, though, Treehouse of Horror has become an annual tradition for the show. You can tell why just by watching the first episode. It's not only a chance to tell The Simpsons' spin on classic horror stories, which is fun on its own, but the episodes are also an opportunity to tell out-of-continuity stories that can break the rules of the show. You can kill off the entire Simpsons family with absolutely no consequences, depict far more gruesome violence, or just have some weird shit happen. Relax, what is mind? No matter, what is matter? Never mind. Treehouse of Horror 1 begins with a parody of the intro to Frankenstein 1931, with Marge emerging behind a curtain to warn the audience that the episode will be scary.
But tonight's show, which I totally wash my hands of, is really scary.
Which is kind of ironic because the episode is pretty tame compared to future Treehouse of Horrors. Bart even seems to predict this in the same episode with a Friday the 13th reference.
Maybe people were easier to scare back then.
Oh yeah, like when you look at Friday the 13th Part 1. It's pretty tame by today's standards.
The episode begins proper with what would become a tradition, a totally new intro sequence. In this case, a cemetery sequence featuring tombstone gags, including Garfield, Casper the Friendly Boy, and even Paul McCartney's grave is shown, referencing a famous conspiracy theory about Paul McCartney actually being dead this whole time, and replaced by an imposter. You know what they say about Simpsons predictions? These tombstone gags were occasionally used in future Treehouse of Horror episodes, but they were eventually dropped when the writers of The Simpsons got lazier. The first Treehouse of Horror establishes the typical structure of these episodes, but this episode is the only one to date to actually use the treehouse motif to tell its story. Why are these episodes all called Treehouse of Horror then? Let's not worry about that. Treehouse of Horror episodes were inspired by the EC comics of the 50s and almost always feature three stories with wraparound segments to tie things together. In this case, the Simpsons children are exchanging horror stories in Bart's treehouse as their father Homer, a 36-year-old man, returns from a night of trick-or-treating.
What a haul this year. I love Halloween.
The first story told in the episode by Lisa isn't actually depicted in the episode. You only catch the tail end of the tale, which is the urban legend When a Stranger Calls was inspired by.
We have traced a call. It's coming from the floor below you. Get out of the house! But it was too late.
You know, if there ever is a last Treehouse of Horror episode, which is unlikely, the final segment should be the story Lisa tells, with Bart responding that she's already told that story before.
Yawn. I heard that when I was in the third grade. It's not scary.
Two of the stories shown in the episode are told by Bart. The first is Bad Dream House, which is a general parody of haunted house stories with Amityville Horror, Poltergeist, and even some Shining thrown in the mix. Future Treehouse episodes would get a lot more obvious and on the nose with their parodies. Essentially, the Simpsons move into a suspiciously cheap mansion in Springfield, which looks a lot like the Addams Family Manor.
I still can't believe how inexpensive it was.
Motivated seller, Marge.
It is revealed very quickly that the place is haunted, but despite this, because Homer is such a cheapskate, he's willing to try to live with the house's threats and interdimensional portals.
You must kill them all. They all must die.
The story reaches a head when the Simpsons are compelled to all kill each other. It's a very quick, straightforward story.
Homer! Bart! God, Lisa, Maggie, stop it!
Sorry, Bart. Sorry, Mom.
Ultimately, the house decides to kill itself instead of living with the Simpsons family. If this was a later episode, it would have ended with something grim happening to the Simpsons themselves. It's only really an unhappy ending for the house.
It chose to destroy itself rather than live with us. You can't help but feel a little rejected.
This Treehouse of Horror episode is also the first episode Alf Clausen was composer for, and his theme for Bad Dream House is genuinely creepy and sells the horror of the story. I give Bad Dream House 3 Treehouses out of 5. The next story is an actual specific parody, Hungry Are the Damned, which is a spoof of a Twilight Zone episode called To Serve Man. The story is also notable for introducing Kang and Kodos, the drooling extraterrestrial hallmarks of Treehouse of Horror episodes, having appeared in every Simpsons Halloween episode.
Anyone from a species that has mastered intergalactic travel, raise your hand!
Their designs were inspired by aliens from the covers of EC comic books. The story involves the Simpsons family being abducted by aliens, who appear to be courteous and simply want to take the family to their home planet for a banquet. Lisa, though, a jaded cynic, insists that something else must be afoot and discovers a cookbook for eating humans, only to be proven wrong twice. This gag is the funniest moment in the episode. It's when the show is starting to really develop its unique style of nonsensical humor.
You would have been treated like gods and lived forever in beauty.
I give Hungry Are the Damned 3 Treehouses out of 5 again. The final story of the episode is either the best of the episode or the weakest, depending on who you ask. Lisa reads Edgar Allan Poe's short story, The Raven, and it is literally just a faithful retelling of the story with Homer as the protagonist and Bart as the raven.
Take thy beak from off my heart and take thy form from off my door!
Nevermore.
The comedy of this segment is more in how earnestly Homer recites Edgar Allan Poe. Writing, but it also features some great early animation on the show, with the story told through dynamic camera angles that give it a cinematic feel. The notable aspect of this segment, though, is that it's narrated by James Earl Jones, who tells the story fantastically.
Soon again, I heard a tapping, something louder than before.
But he also makes a couple cameos in earlier segments, first as a moving guy.
A buck. I'm glad there's a curse on this place.
Huh?
And secondly, as Sarek, the preparer, Kang and Kodos' cook.
Take all you want, but eat all you take.
The Raven segment is a well-done piece of art, but it's neither funny or scary, and doesn't really feel like a Simpsons take on the story. It kind of seems like it was a chance to bring some prestige to the show and win it another Emmy. I give The Raven 3 Treehouses out of 5 yet again. Overall, Treehouse of Horror 1 is a fine Halloween special on its own, but it was made early on when The Simpsons was still finding its comedy voice. It's not a very funny episode, and it isn't all that scary, despite Homer losing sleep over a bird. It's a good start to a time-honored tradition, though. I give The Simpsons Treehouse of Horror 1, overall, 3 treehouses out of 5. Join me next time as I revisit Treehouse of Horror 2. See you there! If you liked this video, like it, and if you loved it, click the subscribe and bell buttons for more vids. I'd also like to thank these fine folks pledged my shout-out tier on Patreon for all their kind support. Videos like this wouldn't be possible without all their help. Thank you for watching. See you next time. Dr. Wolf Euless signing out.